Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Creatively Inspired. This is Denise and my friends call me Dee. I was hoping to try my first tutorial here and we'll see how it goes. I was working on these little snowmen for my Christmas tree, our family Christmas tree, and as I'm finding little things, I figured let me try and make them for YouTube as well. So here they are. Made a few of them here. They're really adorable. They're just from the clothespins that you can get from the Dollar Tree. I think I have some here that I may be able to show you. Let's see. Somewhere. You can get a whole pack of them. Literally for a dollar. A bunch. Sorry. Wasn't that prepared there. Okay. There we go. Get a whole bunch. And this is a really cute little craft to do with them. Very, you know, affordable to actually do. You need some yarn. Yarn will help. Whatever kind of yarn you have. So you can make your little hats for the snowmen. I just happen to have this one here, the black. Let me see. So you do that there. I use that. Then I just cut out, depending, I figured that I would cut out the color of cardstock that was the same color as the yarn. It would make it easier in case I had some spaces or anything, because I've never made these before, so I don't know. I didn't want them to be, you know, see-through or anything, but I had some cardstock. I just, like, I cut it, and then I fold it to make it a little extra thick, a little thicker, but I guess, you know, it depends on you, on the size and all that good stuff there. So you're going to use some cardstock. Your clothespins, of course. Then you'll need to cut. You'll need to cut your yarn approximately, what is that, like 3 inches or so? But, of course, you know, you have to judge for yourself what size you want them to be and all that. You got to play around and so you cut up what you need there for your hats. This one here I had a little bit too much, but I'm going to do a white hat for this one that I'm going to be showing you. So I have some white cut up for that there. I'm going to be using this type of ribbon here for around his neck. And then, what else did I have? Let's see. So, any type of ribbon. The best thing I found, if you can find it, this one here is the Craft Smart. It's the chalky acrylic paint. This stuff is actually amazing because if you're like me and you just don't want to keep waiting and stuff, this pretty much dries as you're actually, you know, painting it on your projects and whatever it is. It pretty much dries as you're doing it, so you can start going to work on it as soon as possible. And that's why I prefer this here. I've got to actually pick up some more. I've only got a few of these. I mean, you could always do your own if you have the little ones, you know, inexpensively, and you just mix some, you know, plaster of Paris in and you can make it the chalk paint yourself. Maybe I'll have to do a tutorial on that at one point, because I was out looking at different places and I couldn't find any more and any more colors that I wanted. So I thought maybe, you know, maybe I'll just have to just use the ones that I have, because I have a lot of these little acrylic paints, and I'm thinking I'll just use this and make my own out of it, the chalk paint. And the reason why is because it's just great coverage, and the fact that it dries so fast, very, very helpful. Then you need, like, some Sharpies so you can draw your little face or, you know, whatever you want to use. It's all on you. That's whatever you want to use. That's the best part about it. Stickles, that always helps. I used a little bit of the Distress ink as well. This one here was the Walnut Stain, because I wanted to give it a little, you know, aged look to it, like primitive type of look. So I used that there as well with the, you know, the Distress tool there. I used that to do that. Also, you know, I used some sequins as well. And I picked these here for the little buttons, and let's see, I use this one I think I might have, I'm not sure where I got this. They might have even had this at one point to, at a Dollar Tree, you know, just shop around. I've had this for a really long time, but I used this one. I was going to try and, use some stuff that I have, and I was going to make the wires, you know, paint like the silver one rusty looking, you know, to make it really antique looking, primitive looking, or however you say that word. But I decided, you know, let me just use this here and see how it goes. And this wire worked out really well. You know, on the snowman, as you can see, that I did up here. And I added, I added little sequins on there, and little turns and stuff. But you can see. And of course, you know, I used the stickles. I just kind of used my finger and rubbed it all on there and whatnot. I'm not sure if I wanted to try to define these other ones that I have here. This pom-pom came out really cute on there, but, you know, try to define maybe the difference between this to this there with a little bit of the walnut stain, but I was like, oh, I'll just leave it like that. But okay, so that's pretty much the stuff that you need there. So what I did was I took this clothespin. Oh, and hot glue gun, by the way. That's always a good thing. You gotta have that. But, alright, so what I did was I took this apart. I kind of just went like this here. And see how you just, you know, kind of just take this here. Wiggle it all out of there. I'm trying to watch the screen as well as I'm doing this here. Alright, so then what I did was I have like some parchment paper, which I love getting parchment paper because nothing like the glue and everything, like everything comes off it and whatnot. So if you're painting little things like this, it won't stick. It'll come off nice. But like I said, if you're using all this kind of, you know, chalk paint and whatnot, it dries very fast when you're painting it. So you want to paint your clothespins when you're making this. And what you're going to do is when you paint them, so you're going to paint them. You're going to let them dry, obviously. And then let me see. Where did I put my clothespins? I have them somewhere. somewhere. But I just had them in my hands to show you the ones that are done already. Got the hat. So we have these here. And I know I have something. There it is. All right. So these are them painted. I have them painted here. You know, and I don't care that if it's all, you know, a little not so perfect there. But what you do is you're going to take them, you know, usually this is how they, you know, they are with that little, this little piece right there, like that way, right? And then, you know, when you squeeze them like that. But this is what you're going to do. You're going to turn them around backwards, the opposite way, like this here. And you want to put them like this. Some of them are different. This one, like for instance, is larger. This is a different one. I don't know where I might have got that one. And this one here had a larger hole in the center. But you can always work around that and cover it up. So this is what I did. I have my two pieces here painted, already dry. Now I'm going to try and grab my glue gun here while I'm talking to you. And I have this one right now in which I really don't like because I can't even tell you how much. Look, here's my little convenient glue thing I made. I made this here, you know, out of chipboard. The bottom is like a one of those little tile trivets that you would use like for cooking and whatnot that I've got at a thrift store. I put that down. Actually you can see that probably in there. Same as one of those kind of things. Hot plate thing, and then here is like a piece of silicone that I got from Dollar Tree, cut it to fit inside, but look at this, it drips nonstop. What a waste of glue. I mean, you can almost make a full glue stick with all this waste, you know, whatever, but it works for me. It's really cool, because this is what I do here with my, you know, instead of like throwing it down on the ground or whatever, I mean, laying it aside and stuff with all the drippage. Whoops, we don't want to shut it off. All right, so that's my little glue gun thing here. Very easy and simple to make. So what I did here now, but I don't like this. I've got to take out the other one that I have and use it. It's much better. It doesn't even hardly any waste or anything. But this is one I had. I'll show you that one in a minute. But first I want to just show you. So you're going to take your clothespin on the other side here. And you're going to actually just, you know, put a little bit of hot glue on it. Just like that. Okay, let's see if I can get this out of the way. You're going to get the other side. I love the smell of hot glue. Burning. I don't know why. I'm going to just put it together right there. And just be careful, depending on the temperature of your glue gun that you have. Mine's a high temp, but there's, you know, sometimes I don't feel it because I have nerve damage in my hands. And sometimes I don't feel it. And I'll notice, like, a burn later and think, where'd that come from? You know. So, you want to get that glued on. Then, once you have that glued on, make sure you have that really nice and secure. You don't really want it leaking all out or anything. But, once you have, you get all your little, like, glue webs off there. Alright, so, what I did was, is I grabbed out 3 markers out of my Sharpies. I love these Sharpies. They're the fine points. I got the whole little, you know, the fine, and I love these little cases. These are the large iris cases, but I use this for a lot of storage. I always look for them. I try to stay with the clear. I won't get them if they don't, if they're not clear. Okay, so now I have my Sharpies. Then, of course, you want to make your little face, you know, on them here. Let's see which side I like better. I like, maybe that's fine. This one didn't seem like it closed as well, but that's okay. That's what you're going to do here is, hopefully you can see what I'm doing. I'm just going to draw a little face, you know. Oh, what? Now this one's not going to work because you know I am filming. Let's see. There we go. It's starting to come out. Work it. Okay. Of course you can make any kind of face you want. However you want to. But this is what, you know, I'm going to do for mine. I'll do that and do that there. What I've been doing, I think what I did is try to make little, like, rosy cheeks on the ones that I did with the white hat. Oops, wrong side. You gotta, like, it's really hard when you're trying to look through this thing and do a thing at the same time. All right, look. These are 2 different types of orange, and I figured maybe I'll use the lighter orange first and try to draw, like, the little markings in with the darker one for the nose, but this is what I did here. Okay, so you've got your, I don't know if you can see. I'm just going to draw a cute little carrot, I guess you want to say. We just want to do a point. Just kind of go like that. It's not a big deal. Right? Hey, it looks like a nose. Right? That's all we need. But that's what we're looking for. Now I'm going to get the darker one. And then I'm just going to draw a little line there, a little line there. Just to make a little, like, you know, not that it's really noticeable, but make the little difference in there of the lines, like that. Okay, so now we have the face. So what I want to do next is add in the little what I chose, whoops, what I've chose to be the scarf. So you just kind of put it on, like so, and you tie it. I burned the edges already on my candle, and these you don't even have to put close, and it melts so fast, so you have to be really careful. Just be careful with ever, like, whatever you choose for your laces and whatnot that you want to use for the scarf, for the snowman scarf. I'll tie it into a knot. Hopefully you're seeing this fine. So then we have this on like that. Now, let me see if I have a scrap paper here. When I do this part, I don't want to get a little too dirty, but now I'm going to use my vintage stain distress ink, which I love my distress inks. I'm not sure if I want to keep continuing to use the big ones. I'll switch over to the minis, but if anything, I would just rather buy all the refills so I have all the ink refills, and then I'll go from there. We'll see. Okay, so now I distressed, I've got the walnut stain on here. Take some off, right? I'm just going to kind of, you know, brush a little on. You don't want to go too much. It's, you got to be a little careful. You don't want to, hopefully I'm in frame here. Because you can see all of it. Try to make the perimeter, the old vintagey looking kind of like a snowman. And then I also do it to the scarf. I try. Back doesn't matter as much. Let's see. Are we in there? And just kind of do it like that. I mean, you can do it before you put it on, however you want to do it. But this is what I was doing. I figured I would just show you the way I was doing it. And so now, there is the snowman, little antiquing on it. Now, the thing, let's see. Next part. I don't know where the one that I had open was. Oh, there it is. I'm not even sure where I had picked this up from. But, alright, I dropped something. I need to pick things up when I drop them because of my dogs. They'll take them from me. And they'll run. And so now I have, I guess Studio G. I can't even remember where I got these from. Of course, you can use whatever you want. You can even use your marker. It's just, the little hole's not a big deal. But some of them are bigger. And if you want to, like, cover those up, you want to use something here. But I like the small ones, and I'm thinking, I don't know if I want to use what size. I did, I think I'm going to use the little ones, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my multimedia mat finish, obviously. Was it in? Usually I have it in the little thing there, but I'm going to do this. I'm going to go kind of like this. There, I'm going to put, can you see that? Let's see. A little bit there with my finger. And there. And there. We'll see how that goes. That one like fit right in somehow. That worked out. And I mean, I know they say self-adhesive, but just in case, I just reinforce it. I was looking at the camera, the viewfinder thing, the screen, and see. Okay. So, we got that there. I'm going to do that because it dries. No gloss. So we can do that. This little look, I took the other one off. See, this is my dilemma. I always do that with these things. I have that quickie stick too, but I still. No, that one went under my nail. Let me see. Am I even in frame? Okay. Okay. Flip over the other way. When it's really that small, it's hard. Oh! Get it on. Oh! Okay. I have that one there. We'll see, right? Where'd that one go? Oh! Did I lose it? Did I lose it? And let's see. Oh! What the... Things are so freaking tiny. Hold on. Get it off my finger. The glue will be dry and it'll be more on my finger. Yeah. I don't want to use hot glue because that's a pain in the butt when you're doing something this little. So, I don't know. Let's hope that just dries on like that. Move it all over. There. Okay. So there, my little pieces are on there. I do not like when this sticks up like that. So what I usually do too is actually get a little piece of the, a little bit of the my hot glue. Kind of little dab there. Yeah. You just kind of put it on. Use your nails or whatever. And just be careful. Like I said, you don't want to burn yourself. Alright. That one's weird. That one fell in, but that's cool. Alright. So we'll remove that there. Okay. So, what I had done is I had just cut, like, some strips of cardstock. This one wasn't even, this is like a Michael's cardstock. It's not even very thick or anything, but what I did was I cut it, and because it wasn't so thick, I cut it, and then I folded it in half. Now, what I did was I tried to figure out, like, you know, what would be a good size around the head, and how I did it was is that I come to the conclusion that my pinky, it worked, like this, like so, right? So I kind of did it like that. And then I glued, you know, did a little piece of cardstock, like, glue, the hot glue there. I attached it together, and then, let's see, well, first of all, you know, figure out your size, too. I ended up with that kind of a size there, and then you get a little piece like this here that you want to fit right there on you. But don't forget that when you have it with all the yarn on it as well, it's going to be tighter. So not even sure if this is even the correct way of making this here. And like I said, my hands have a little bit of issues with nerve damage and whatnot, so I struggle a bit, but I'm going to show you here. Now, the point of this here is like trying to remember exactly to make the little hat. What you're going to do is you get the, you're going to have like, you have this circle, right? And you stop as far as like, you get your pieces, you know, cut to the length you want, and then you're going to put it together. Whoops. Sorry. You're going to put it together like this here, and you're going to put it through like this. So you're going to have the little piece there and these two pieces down here. You take this inside, and you're going to go like this here, put it through, and pull. And you get this the hat. Now, I bet you these would look so stinking cute if you just made them a little bigger and, you know, you did this and you just made little hats alone just to hang along your tree. I think that would be really, really cute. But this is what it looks like when you do it that way. So, of course, for saving some time here, you know, I got this one all going here. Of course, you want to always make sure that you put them in the same exact way each time. I believe this is how I was doing it. So let's see. So I'm going to do a few like this for you. And we're going to complete this snowman hat. Hold on. Let's see. Pull it up. Now, I seen what these had looked like, you know, on Pinterest. I didn't watch a tutorial on it. Sometimes I just see a picture and I'm like, oh, I can figure that out. So I hope this is how you do it. I'm not sure. But, alright, so keeping that like that there. So, this here kind of hurts my hands to keep doing. But it's also like, you know, it's good therapy for me to use my hands like this, so I don't, you know what they say, you know, use it or lose it. So I do this sometimes, and it's these little things here that help my hands stay functioning because of my fingers. Things that, you know, you may see me just drop things out of nowhere and stuff, but it's all good. It's just part of nerve damage, you know. I get over it. I pick it up. It's just not fun when you drop like a bunch of like toothpicks or something. Oops. Let's see. I gotta keep making sure I'm in frame here. So just bear with me because I've never done tutorial or any of this stuff here on YouTube. And hopefully this is something that you can understand. If there's anything that I could do to make this any better, like play music instead of listening to me talking. No, whichever. Just please, you know, write in the comments below. Let me know if you like what you're seeing. Well, it doesn't matter if you do or you don't anyway, because I'm going to keep making them until I learn how to do better, right? All right. Anyway, just let me know if there's something else I can do that you know that you can help me with. I'm learning as I go. So, I mean, I'm thinking I could probably fit another one here. Obviously, right? But it could be too much. I don't know if I'm doing too much. And I do. You might hear my dog snoring over there because she's always by my feet under my craft desk. All right, let's... Oh. So, all right. So, obviously, at least I did good knowing that I did them in the right direction. You know, so you want to make them all nice and... You know, going the right way and whatnot. Let's see. Now, what I did was... I got a marker. I want this to... I got to flip all these this way. So I used the marker. And I tried to just stop pushing all this stuff through the other side. Because that's what it looked like you should do with these hats. If I'm... You know, making this more difficult than it really is, please let me know. I'd like to know the correct way or an easier way, because if there is an easier way, I wouldn't mind, because I would make some for my tree. Just the hats alone as ornaments, because they could be really cute. So, actually, I'm going to leave this there. So then, I'm going to stop pulling all these little things out. Yeah, I know. My camera straps and whatnot, my little thingies. I just don't have the room. I don't want to be putting holes in the wall to hang things up. It's not something I want to do right now. I'm just trying to do the best I can. Oh my goodness, I'm not even sure where this landed at. I hope that my camera had stopped in the middle of this. I'm not sure what it said. I'm going to have to go check it and see. Alright, so when you flip it all inside out, and you have all that left, you want to make sure that it's all as nice and tight in there as you can get it. I love these little hats. I think they're so stinking adorable. Alright, let me see. So... Now what you want to do is you want to get a spare piece. What I did was I left this in, like so. I really hope that this recorded, because that would be really bad. I have no clue what that camera was saying. I should have been watching the numbers move. Okay, so obviously you want a pom-pom. This is the part. I want it to be... Tie in a knot, however you want to. Then I turned it around, and I kind of did it over there, in case. Can see right there, right? Then I'm gonna take my scissors. That piece obviously isn't gonna do me any justice. Let's get rid of that piece.
pictures right there. Okay. So, this is a little hat. This is a little pom-pom. Yeah. Doesn't make a mess, it can. But what... You know, like, you have to make a mess to be having fun. If you're not making a mess, you're not having fun. That's what I say. Remember being a kid, playing in the dirt, playing in the mud, you always had the best fun. Sometimes, I just cut it down too small, that sucks. But obviously you make your pom-pom to the best you want it on the top. That one's actually kind of cute. So take your snowman, find which angle you like better of the hat. Oops. See, there we go. Dropping. Alright, maybe that. So I'm going to get my glue. Hot glue. And this is what I'm going to do. Yeah. I've got my other glue gun I got to do. Push that on. See how I like it. Make your pom-poms big, make your pom-poms small, however you want to make them. Now, as far as the wire, you cut off as much as you want. I cut off probably like about that much. What is that, like 3-4 inches? Let me see. It is, ooh, well, way off. 1, 2, 3, 4. maybe 7 inches. It depends. Maybe... Probably 6. It depends on what you want to do. Alright, so I already have a piece cut off here. And this is what I did here for my... I started it off here to show you. I added some sequins. I made some little twirls and things on it there. I started off. This part will be the bottom part that I'm going to try to tuck away inside the snowman little thing. But I'll show you here. So, I'm going to find a sequins... I use these little things, obviously. Which one do we end with? We end with the red, so now let me find my silver. My little ones for the silver. Alright, let's see if we can take this out here. So is it... It's not like a million of them that are going to come flying out. Alright, so there's two. I only want one. I get OCD, and I don't want them all over the place. Alright, so here we go. Let's try this with my hands. Okay, so I'm going to like bend this just a little bit. Luckily, for some reason, they just kind of fit. Right like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of roll this here in this direction. Right? Then kind of go like this. Because you don't want it okay. It's really hard when you have nerve damage and stuff to try to grasp onto these things, so doing tutorials for this kind of stuff isn't always like the best thing for me. But let's see. Now I have that there because I want it to stay. Whoops. Then I just want to make this look a little... So I'm just going to roll it. I'm just going to go like this and roll it. And you want to make a little hook there, I guess, right? So there's my pretty little snowman. So on the back, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of feed it through here.
You just want to make it just secure in the back, that's all. And then, for hanging purposes, you want to make sure that on the back, you kind of just put your hot glue, as long as you have it on there, like so. However you want to put this part, I mean, of course, you know, this is your own, however you want to do it. Hang it on your tree. Okay, so I have that. Now let's see. Now, of course, you get your stickles or any kind of glitter glue. And this is kind of what I did. I kind of just add a little like this, my in there. And kind of added like a little up here. And then this is what I did here. When you rub your finger around, I kept mine on the brim and up at the top. Kind of helps some of the shedding, right? And then I started rubbing it all over. Showing my, making it nice and glittery and pretty all over the place. There, like so. You know, then you let it dry. And there you go. Your cute little primitive snowman ornament. It doesn't take very long to make. The most time-consuming part, I would say, would probably be the hat. I mean, it probably wouldn't be as bad for somebody who, you know, doesn't have nerve damage and whatnot to worry about. But I actually love these hats. I think they're adorable. So, yeah, there's, like, all the little snowmen. And I believe I covered all of what we needed. I think they're adorable. So there's different sizes there. And, of course, you can use, you know, whatever you'd like. So hopefully, you know, my first tutorial here was something you could understand. You let it dry. I have a huge mess to do. Clean up here. But, okay. I'm planning on trying to make sure I do tutorials for the rest of the week on different type of Christmas ornaments that I want to do. I want to do angels and a few other little things that are really cute. I have these little bead things that I got from here's one, for instance, like these little cardinals. They're so cute. I got them from AC Moore. And then the other ones were the little reindeer that are really, really cute. You can make little things there. I have all that there. So I really do have a lot of other little cute things to do that I want to hopefully show you. So yeah, hopefully you like that tutorial and I'll be back showing you more. And I guess that's all for today. So I hope you have a happy Halloween. Stay safe and thanks for watching.